We're continuing to work with linear equations in two variables, and in this section we're going to start off finding ordered pair solutions to a linear equation if I give you a value of either the x coordinate or the y coordinate. So here's an example. Find the ordered pair solution of y equals 3 halves x minus 4 corresponding to x equals 6. What this is saying is you want the ordered pair where you're going to put in 6 for x. So what you're looking for is the y coordinate. So how would I get that? Well, I've got y equals 3 halves x minus 4. I'm going to plug in 6 for x. All right, now I'm going to write 6 as 6 over 1. You don't have to do that. And then we simplify the right-hand side. So let's see, 2 goes into 6 3 times. So this gives me 9 minus 4. Everybody agree with that? Because 9 over 1 is 9. So we have 9 minus 4 is 5. So the ordered pair solution that we're looking for is 6, 5. And that's our answer. Let's try it corresponding to some other number. All right, this time it says find the ordered pair solution of y equals 3 halves x minus 4 corresponding to x equals negative 4. So again, we're given the x coordinate of the ordered pair. So for the x coordinate, we're going to put in negative 4 and we're trying to find the y value. So we're going to plug in what for the x value? Negative 4. So again, I'm going to write that as negative 4 over 1 since I'm multiplying by a fraction. And then we simplify this. Now it's going to be negative, right? Because I have a positive times a negative here. And the 2 goes into 4 2 times. So I have 3 times negative 2. So that's negative 6. Be careful with your signs. And negative 6 minus 4 is the same as negative 6 plus negative 4. That's negative 10. So the ordered pair corresponding to when x is 4 is this ordered pair, negative 4, negative 10. All right, here's another one. Find the ordered pair solution of 2x minus 3y equals 12 corresponding to x equals 3. All right, so again, I know the x coordinate is going to be 3, so I could put that in. Now we've got to take this equation over here, 2x minus 3y equals 12, and we're going to plug in 3 in place of x. And now I don't just get to simplify the right-hand side of the equation, I'm going to have to solve for y. So let's see. First, I'm going to simplify the left side, 6 minus 3y equals 12. Then I'm going to subtract 6 from both sides to get negative 3y equals 6. Then I'm going to divide by negative 3. And I finally get the y value of negative 2. So when it's not solved for y like in that previous one, there's a lot more work when you're plugging in that value for x. Now, you should make sure that you didn't make a mistake by checking to make sure that 3 negative 2 really is a solution to that. So if I'm going to take 2x minus 3y equals 12, a quick check, put in 3 for x, negative 2 for y, and make sure it's true. So I have 6. This is minus negative 6 or plus 6 equals 12. So you just want to do a little double check there. So therefore, 3 negative 2 is the order pair we're looking for that problem. All right, how about if we were asked to fill in the blanks to find the ordered pair solutions to y equals 2x minus 5? So we're trying to find three ordered pairs. I could see the x value in two of the ordered pairs and the y value in one. So we need to do three things. We need to find each ordered pair. So let's see. Let's work on the first one. If x is 0, and we put that in this ordered pair, what will y equal? Well, if I'm going to plug in 0, that gives me 2 times 0 minus 5, which is negative 5. So when I plugged in 0, y was negative 5. All right, second one. It tells me what the y value is. So I have to take this equation and I have to plug in 5 for y to figure out what x is. So 5 equals 2x minus 5. Now I've got to solve for x. So I have to add 5 to both sides. So basically, I have 2x is 10. Hopefully, you can see that x is also going to be 5. All right. Last one, we're going to plug in negative 1 for x. So we have 2 times negative 1 minus 5. Y would be negative 7. All right, so what we found are three ordered pair solutions. We filled in the blanks. If you want to write these as ordered pairs, remember how they look. 0, negative 5, 5, 5, and negative 1, negative 7. If you were to graph those three ordered pairs on the xy plane, the rectangular coordinate system, and draw the line through those three points, you would have all the ordered pair of solutions on that line. So let's go ahead and do that. All right, so if we look at these ordered pairs, 0, negative 5, 5, 5, negative 1, negative 7, notice I have plotted those three points on this graph, and now we simply draw the line through those three points. So once you draw the line through those three points, you can convince yourself that every point on that line is a solution. So what you could do is a little check, remember, is figure out one of the points that line's going through. So for instance, I see this point right here. That looks like 3, 1. Let's make sure 3, 1 is a solution. Remember, so we're going to put in 3 for x, right? You're going to put the 3 in for the x, and we're going to put in the 1 for the y, so that would give me 1 equals 6 minus 5. Yep. So looks like I've got the correct graph. So we've done a few things here. We found we filled in this chart to get three ordered pairs on that line, and then we also went ahead and graphed the three ordered pairs and drew the line between them, or through them, and that gives us all the ordered pairs that are solutions to that equation. Now, here's the thing you may wonder. How did, I come up with, well, I'm going to plug in 0 for x or 5 for y or negative 1 for x? When you have a linear equation, you could choose any number you want for x, plug it in, and you'll be able to solve for y. That'll give you an ordered pair. So there are no restrictions on what you put in for one of the variables. So you pick a variable, you pick a number for that variable, and then that's half of your ordered pair. So in general, there are no restrictions, but there's ways of picking easy numbers to start with. So here's an example. Find three ordered pairs for y equals 2x minus 3. We're just going to make a table. And I'm going to pick anything I want for x, and then I'm going to figure out what y is based on that x. So let's do that. Any number you want for x. All right, let's just pick 0, 1, and 2. Simple enough. So let's put in 0 for x. And what does that give me for my y value? So if I simplify that, gives you 0 minus 3, y would be negative 3. What ordered pair is that? 0, negative 3. Let's do the next one. We're going to put in 1 for x. So y would be 2 minus 3 or negative 1. What ordered pair is this? Here's your x, here's your y. 1, negative 1. All right, now let's put in 2 for x. So I have 4 minus 3 is 1, and I've just found 3 ordered pairs from my line. I'm going to go on to another video to show how to get equations in an easy form to do this, and also how to pick easy values for x.